So the act is interesting in itself because it provides you, slaps on various definitions, and it's pretty much entitles one agency to regulate it. But then it goes in to say, okay, customs is also administering agency, so they have core, they have to kind of like co-share the jurisdiction for the Toxic Substances Control Act that regulates chemicals. All right, so whenever you see chemicals, Toxic Substances Control Act, so whenever you see word chemicals, also keep in mind that it's a term of word. And as we shall shortly see, that term of word, understanding the meaning of what applies and what doesn't apply to the Toxic Substances Control Act, can have a great difference on the way you import and can affect whether your merchandise is detained or denied entry once it hits the border. So let's go to that section 13 and see how Toxic Substances Control Act applies to U.S. Customs. And for that matter, customs broker. All right, so here it is. So Congress, this is again the law, Toxic Substances Control Act, passed in 1976. And the Congress declared, the Secretary of Treasury shall refuse entry, shall, meaning it's a must, into the customs territory of the United States, and they say as defined in general note number 2, but it gives us an excuse to preview what the customs territory of the United States means. It means the mainland, Alaska, so all 50 states, Hawaii. Then it includes District of Columbia, and it also includes Puerto Rico, which is not a state, it's a territory, and it is considered part of the customs territory. All other territories, protectorates, or whatever they are called, they are not customs territories. So Guam would not be customs territory of the United States. The islands that were taken during the World War, such as Antilles, they would not be. Saipan would not be. Those all are islands in the Pacific. In the Caribbean, we have U.S. Virgin Islands. U.S. Virgin Islands are not part of customs territory of the United States. In fact, they're governed by... they acquired it from the Dutch. I believe they acquired it from the Dutch. I haven't inquired much into the history. I only looked at what customs has published on the website and I found them to be wrong. Because they say Denmark, and they think people of Denmark are Dutch. No, it's people of Holland. So it shows you the misunderstanding even on the part of customs. It was posted on the customs news webpage. But irrespective of that, U.S. Virgin Islands is not customs territory. Only those three things: District of Columbia, 50 states, and Puerto Rico. Okay. So the Congress says so. If any chemical substance mixture or article containing chemical substance or mixture offered for such entry shall be denied. Shall be refused the entry, so you cannot declare it, you cannot clear it. That's it. You just wasted your time by trying to bring this merchandise into the United States. Because if it fails to comply with any rule under this act or is offered for entry in violation of Section 5, Section 6, or Title 4. All right. 5, 6, or 4, all right, or order of civil action, but mostly we're dealing with those stuff. So what? So pursuant also to that, see, it says Secretary of Treasury. Remember, this law was passed in 1976. Since then, in 2002, the Customs as an agency was transferred to the Department of Homeland Security. So it would most likely be the the Secretary of Homeland Security, not Treasury, who is responsible for this. But nevertheless, let's take a look at what those sections stand for. Okay, so section six. Let me pull it up a little bit more. So section five deals with manufacturing or processing notices. Basically, whenever you make a new chemical, it's a new molecular formula, combination thereof. It's something which is newly designed. You cannot just bring it in to the country. You have to go through this procedural protocol of notifying Environmental Protection Agency of existence, listing the chemicals, going through the motions, which usually for a lot of customs brokers are not of relevant concern, unless the importer comes in and says, "Hey, licensed customs broker, help me out. I have this chemical. I don't know what to do. Is it compliant? Not compliant? Is it new?" And those are the questions that you may have to deal with, which do happen. So another section which is regulated by customs is the hazardous chemical substances and mixtures. Those are the case-by-case basis. And we shall discover it by way of example how to look it up. But it so happened that those chemicals that were used prior to 1976, they were sort of grandfathered in into the act, and in a way they weren't considered hazardous, right? I think that's changing now, and we also shall see that in a bit. But basically, any chemical is likely to be subject to the Toxic Substance Control Act, meaning that it is subject to the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, and so we have EPA, Environmental Protection Agency, which can say to customs, "No, you can't bring this product into the country," and customs must oblige. All right, so let's take a look at what kind of chemicals are part of the Toxic Substance Control Act and what chemicals are not, and what applications does it carry for licensed customs brokers. So term chemical substance, as Congress defined, means any organic and inorganic substance or particular molecular identity, including blah, blah, blah. So very broad definition. So the way to understand it is to see what it is not. And what it is not is included in the paragraph B, subparagraph B, and it says the following chemicals are not subject to the Toxic Substance Control Act, and there is a laundry list which includes pesticides, which does not mean you get a free ride on pesticides, because pesticides are subject to separate rules and regulations, and they are subject to another day discussion. But customs has also tested on the regulations that that apply to the pesticides and intesticides, fungicide, and rodenticide act, which is also the province of EPA. Tobacco or any tobacco products. We just talked about the excise taxes, right? So we have tobacco products, and those tobacco products are also outside of jurisdiction of Environmental Protection Agency's Toxic Substance Control Act. Then we have articles for sale which are subject to the tax imposed by scripting section 4181 of the Internal Revenue Code. So if you basically what it is this is arms and ammunition. So you have ammunition, so you have bullets, so you have gunpowder. Gunpowder is made out of chemicals. Those guys are outside, so you have pretty much guns and ammo. Then we have FDA stuff, right? Food, food additive, drug, cosmetic, or device. If it is any of those, then it's also outside of toxic substance controller. So food, drugs, devices. A very interesting point of note for this agency jurisdiction. So you kind of, as we dwell through this customs regulatory world, what we find is a lot of stuff. Oh, by the way, I didn't mention that this Title 7 deals with lead, stuff like lead paint, chemicals containing lead, because lead has been found to be an unhealthy product for the human beings. All right, so, but basically what we saw is so those are the agencies, and we have a lot of overlap. So we have FDA, we have USDA, which is the United States Department of Agriculture, you have Customs, you have EPA, you know. So in other words, you're gonna have like a big mess, right? And it can get kind of messy, but one of the things, one of the responsibilities for a licensed customs broker is kind of like go through this maze and be able to understand who has asserts particular jurisdiction over this product, because if you know if this product has jurisdiction, for example, for United States Department of Agriculture, then you know which rules to apply. You apply USDA rules. If it is Food and Drug Administration, you apply FDA rules, and everyone has a separate thing. So, for example, this laser is, even though it's in no way medical, it is no way like a drug, it is considered to be a device which has to go through the Food and Drug Administration declaration motions. I believe form FDA 2877, something like that. We have to declare, because and since this one was made in China, it has declaration about its radiation emission standards. So basically, even some products which you may never think of are applicable, they do come under jurisdiction of an agency, and if you don't comply, then you may be in trouble. So going back to the food, we have shared jurisdiction for food products and between USDA, US Department of Agriculture, and FDA, Food and Drug Administration. Just to get a head start, the dividing line is if you have meat, poultry, eggs, that's USDA. FDA, it's pretty much all other food. Again, this is very rough, but this is a good rule of thumb that will work for the purposes of figuring out, besides customs, who else I have to attune to, who else I have to go to make sure that the product comes into the country legally. But this is an exception list. So if it's any of those stuff, including this stuff too, because it applies over here, because food includes this stuff, not only FDA stuff, but also USDA stuff as far as meat, poultry, and eggs are concerned. So if you have any of this, they are not subject to the toxic substance controller. But, so you may think as a licensed custom broker, okay, great, I just figured it out and the game is over. Not so fast, because the Secretary of Treasury came down to the Commissioner of Customs, and the Commissioner of Customs asked its people to make some kind of rulings and regulations, from which there emerged set of regulations which are covered under title, under chapter, part 12. So let's take a look at what those regulations look like. So we were at the IRS. Well, let's go to Title 19, which is more closer to our home, customs duties. Part 12. And all the way to the bottom, we have chemical substances, bulks, and aspartate mixture. So pretty much this regulation from 12.118 through 12.127 is dedicated as regulations which customs promulgated pursuant to the Toxic Substance Control Act, which Congress said, you guys make some kind of regulation, and this is what they made. All right. So remember I mentioned that Toxic Substance Control Act is still work in progress. And for that purposes, let me, since it's mandated by the EPA, I think it's very helpful to see what EPA has to say about it, because there has been some recent developments that are applicable. Before I dive into that, though, with these regulations, one of the most essential things for licensed customs broker, and for that matter, the customs broker exam, is the part section 12.121, which is a reporting requirement. Because what happens for U.S. licensed customs broker, the merchandise hits the border, and you have to determine, is it within Toxic Substances Control Act, or is it not? Is it one of those things, or is it some other chemical? And since we live in the industrial world, we have a lot of chemicals coming back and forth, so likelihood of you coming across the chemical is very, very good. All right. Once you determine, and once you determine that it is not, because let's say it's a food product, or it's a meat and poultry, or it's a tobacco, or guns and ammo, pesticides, whatever, the game is not over. Now, according to this reporting requirement, you have to make a negative declaration. So, in other words, you don't say, okay, great, it's not subject to the Toxic Substance Control Act, that's it, hands off, move on. No, you have to file certification attesting that it is not subject to the Toxic Substance Control Act. If it is subject to Toxic Substance Control Act, this is a different story. You have to say it complies with the requirements, or it doesn't, right? If it doesn't, of course, there will be problems. So you better make sure that the product that you bring in, you go through the due diligence before you bring the product into the country. For some chemicals, you even have to mandatory prior notice, because they deem hazardous and there is a list which is increasing and increasing. Before you even bring it in, you have to notify it. You have to make a prior notification that you intend to bring this chemical in.